we take a look at it, the numbers are similar, but that reach advantage for Zab Judah could be important because he needs to fight from a distance, and he wants to catch Garcia, as we said, as he comes in. He can't be on the inside slugging with him or right in the pocket.
Guys, one thing to notice, there's a lot of security separating them. They don't want them near each other even before them, though.
Gentlemen, I gave you instructions in your separate dressing room. Please obey my commands, respect the bell, and above all, protect yourself at all times. Touch gloves. Touch, touch. Thank you.
One of the best referees in the business, Steve Smoker, administering final instructions, extra security in the ring. The gentlemen in the red t-shirts to ensure there was no extracurricular activity prior to the opening bell. There has been plenty of drama leading up to this fight, but the verbal and social media salvos will now be replaced by the physical punches in what has become a rancor-filled grudge match for the unified junior welterweight championship. The bell in round one, the forecast calls for fistic fireworks. We'll see if the meteorologist is right for a change.
They expect, the Garcia camp does, that Zab Judah will try and get off to a very quick start.
Lunges in with a right hand to the body. Judah working the body with that right hand.
Zab, a very good jab for a southpaw, very sharp. Look for him to use it a lot and try to dictate it with it in the first round.
This is Judah's 296th professional round. He has fought more championship rounds, 137 now, than Garcia's fought total rounds, this being his 129th.
We hear the Judah chants.
The champion Garcia in the snakeskin, black, white, and green. The challenger Judah in the black and white.
A counter right hand by Garcia there.
Yeah, we know Garcia has an excellent left hook. He's got a pretty good right hand, which he hopes will be in evidence here tonight. You know what's interesting? We think of Garcia as the puncher. Zab Judah's knockout percentage is higher than Garcia's at 69% to 64%. So Zab Judah has some pop as well.
29 of Judah's 42 career wins have come inside the distance. Garcia has 16 knockouts on his resume with a perfect 25-0 record as the crowd is on fuego here at Barclays Center for this main event.
Nice straight left hand to the stomach there by Judah. You see Garcia trying to loop that right hand around the guard.
Oh, right hand connects by the champion.
A lot of southpaws look for the straight right hand. They know right handers are going to throw that right hand straight. So I think Garcia is trying to surprise Judah by looping it around instead.
The atmosphere in here is truly electric. And if these fighters can produce anything of interest, and we expect them to, this crowd's going to be very, very animated.
Final 60 seconds of the opening round as the champion launches another right hand to the body. Again, another right by Garcia as Judah looks to establish the jab. Triple pumps the jab from the southpaw stance.
Zab Judah's moved mostly to his left in this fight, staying away from the left hook of Garcia, but Garcia's taken advantage of that by landing right hands.
Yeah, and it's, and even if they haven't all landed cleanly, it's controlling Zab. And Zab tries that right uppercut on the inside. He missed it, but he went for it, trying something different.
Double jab by the challenger, Judah. Garcia swinging and missing with the right.
The Judah camp hopes that Garcia will lunge with the right or the left hook where Judah can counterpunch him.
And Danny's staying patient himself. He'll take the right hand to the stomach if that's all Zab gives him.
A close opening round here between the champion Danny Garcia, former champion Zab Judah, as we go to round two.
Let's breathe. Come on, Tay, what do you got? Here, reach up. Here, Pete, listen, go to your right. Keep going to your left, okay? Keep going to your left. Step your right hand up. You touch him. Listen, he's dropping. He's trying to come up with an overhand left. He's dropping his left, his right. Watch for that.
All right, thank you.
That right hook, sitting there. All right, you got to control this, man. Control this fight. Control it with your jab. Don't let him get off first.
Round two underway.
How often does this happen? In the first round, Garcia threw 41 punches, Judah threw 42, and they both landed 8 punches according to show stats.
And Garcia just landed another nice right hand. That's two of them as Judah looks to land the jab.
Neither guy right now putting a lot of muscle behind their offense. They're just trying to find the range, see if they can touch the opponent first before trying to load up.
And Paulie, you made a good point. The right hand by Garcia is freezing Jab Judah right now. Even when he throws it, it's stopping Judah from throwing anything.
And you know, this round he came out throwing it straight. You know, last round he looped it the entire round. This time he came out throwing it straight. I guess trying a little trickery, seeing if Zab was looking for that looping one this round. Instead, it came out straight.
Inviting our viewers to get involved via social media and NFL quarterback Mike Vick taking in the action. He's picking Danny Swift in 8. Swift made the bold prediction of stopping Judah in 4.
Michael Vick had better pick him. He's the Philadelphia Eagles quarterback, and Danny's from Philadelphia.
And a big Eagles fan.
Yeah, exactly. He came with full Eagles paraphernalia to the fighter meeting.
Stiff right hand to the body, followed up by an overhand right by Garcia.
And they're not all landing cleanly, but they're starting to land as Judah returns the favor with a left hand to the body himself. And what they're doing is they're keeping Zab under control. Aside from the pulling jab, Zab snaps it out once in a while. Danny controlling Judah.
It is intriguing that even with no jabs landed by Garcia, this is fascinating. You can control a fight with something else. And we pointed out he's controlling it with the lead right hand.
Two right hands from Garcia connect. Under a minute remaining in the second round.
Now Judah's starting to let go with that left hand.
Which he has to do. And yeah, he should be landing a counter left sometimes when Garcia throws the right hand.
But that's the thing, Al. Garcia mixes the right hand. Sometimes it comes looping, sometimes it comes straight. It's hard to time it. Do you keep your glove in front of you? Keep the glove in front of your chin, or you keep it on the side of your face? Because if you mistime it, you're going to get hit clean.
That's a great point.
Both fighters were Olympic team alternates. Judah in 96, Garcia in 2008.
Both guys more than willing to engage this round. Starting to open up.
Garcia started boxing at the age of 10, went 107-13 as an amateur as Judah puts together a two-punch combination. Judah started boxing at the age of 6 and went 110-5 as an amateur. Good action in round 2 as we go to 3.
Oh, there's a shot by Judah. Landed at the bell. Garcia smiles. The clean best punch of the fight so far for Zab Judah.
Early in that round, Garcia throwing to the body where he does throw very well. And again, that right hand is stopping Zab Judah. Again, a good example of it. Zab unable to counter it. But then later in the round, this was the left hand that Paulie was talking about, or at least one of them that he landed toward the end of the round. It wasn't perfect, but he's starting to find the range with that punch. And right at the end of the round, that was the left hand that I think did more damage to Danny Garcia. So it's heating up.
Garcia, one of only 5 current world champions to hold more than one alphabet title in the same division. The others, Canelo Alvarez, Andre Ward, Juan Francisco Estrada, and Vladimir Klitschko. As round 3 gets underway here, Judah looking again to establish the jab at the get-go. Garcia coming in with the right hand.
You see Garcia kind of pawing with that straight right, then turning southpaw and throwing the right hook. A little creativity by Garcia. And these are the subtle things that I talk about to people, what Danny Garcia does. He does these little subtle things. He's tricky. He may not be as athletically gifted as Judah, but he makes things work. He studies his opponent. He makes adjustments. And you see him doing these little subtle things, and that was one of them.
Good head movement by Judah. Very slick defensively. Has always had the tools to be an all-time great, and he's been at the top of the mountain before and getting yet another opportunity here at the age of 35 to become unified 140-pound champion.
The Garcia camp feels that what Zab Judah brings this fight solely is the left hand, and so far he hasn't been able to land that. And the power punches landed clearly. Garcia, almost all those are right hands. He's thrown almost no left hooks of those 29. And he's clearly outlanding Judah by a wide margin in terms of power shots.
Now, you make mention of the fact that the Garcia camp worries only about Judah's left hand. By throwing the right hand so much and mixing it up, you're forcing Judah to keep the left hand in his pocket. He has to keep it by his face to guard that defense because the right hands are coming from weird angles. So he can't always let go of his left hand for fear that a wild right hand might catch him.
Yep, that's a really great point.
Midpoint of the third round, Garcia loading up with the right hand. Left hook from Judah. Judah goes downstairs with a 1-2 combination. Garcia unleashes a straight right. Double pump on the jab by Judah. Things heating up here in round three at close quarters. Judah again with the double jab upstairs. Garcia able to sneak a right hand to the body.
Still early in the fight, but eventually Judah's going to have to start taking a little bit more chances with that left hand. Still early, though. He still has time.
Under a minute remaining in the third. Garcia again coming forward. Lunges with that right hand. Quick follow-up with the right. Misses with that. Sweeping right hand. Judah now with a straight left hand. Final 30 seconds of the third round.
You see, a few seconds back, Judah landed a straight left hand, got it a clinch, and smiled at Garcia's corner.
Well, Judah still very fast at the age of 35, doing a good job of bobbing and weaving and great head movement.
There he goes again with that straight left hand and a clinch. Man found a little something there.
Three rounds are in the books here at the Barclays Center in Brooklyn. Garcia versus Judah. As we mentioned earlier tonight, the winner of this unified 145 40-pound championship is expected to face the winner of the May 18th showdown between Lamont Peterson and the hard-hitting Lucas Matisse. That's coming your way Saturday, May 18th here on Showtime Championship Boxing.
Well, this is a talent-rich division, and just the possibility, and it's a good possibility, that we'll see that winner take on tonight's winner, I think, is fun for all boxing fans. 140 pounds filled with talent.
Yeah, a lot of it's almost like fantasy boxing. You mix and match the opposition, and you'll have great fights. Keep in mind, Judah already did fight Matisse, but it was a bit controversial. I'm sure nobody would mind seeing it again.
A great crowd on hand here at the Barclays Center in Brooklyn for tonight's championship doubleheader. Earlier tonight, we saw New York resident Peter Kid Chocolate Quillen retain the WBO middleweight championship. At stake in the main event, the WBA and WBC 140-pound titles, the champion Danny Garcia in the black, white, and green, the challenger Zab Judah in the black and white. Round four underway.
Now, Danny Garcia's fought three lefties before, including Mike Arnaudas, and he seems comfortable. You know, he's using primarily the right hand, not mixing in the left hook to keep the southpaw there, but he's doing very well.
One thing to notice, at the end of the last round, Judah finally started having some success laying low with his left hand. I want to see if he can continue that momentum early in this round. He let go of a nice left hand a few seconds ago.
He walked into a right hand from Garcia.
It's important here. It's a crucial part of the fight for Judah. He needs to start establishing a little bit of respect as Garcia's starting to walk him down a little bit.
Garcia is walking him down with that right hand. Couple of left hooks to the body, short left hands. Double pump jab from Judah. Comes in with that swimming jab right uppercut.
That's the thing. The variation will keep the other guy busy and a little bit defensive.
Under 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth round. Straight right to the body by Judah.
Danny Garcia is a very solid, competent fighter.
There's a straight left hand.
He is not great at anything. He's good at everything. And what that makes for is the sum of the parts is special.
Garcia doing a good job of parrying a lot of the shots from Judah as we near the midpoint of the fourth frame.
And he may not be great at anything, but he's shown himself to be an overall great fighter.
Absolutely, yeah.
Paul, you mentioned the fact that Judah has to start establishing that left. He's really kept it in his holster for the large part of this fight.
Yeah, and that's due to the right hands of Garcia. They're not always hard, but they're coming at weird angles, and they're forcing Judah to keep a defensive hold on his left hand.
Both now attacking the body. And a nice left hook That trademark for Garcia, who smiles and nods at Judah. I got you. And now Judah's saying, yeah, but you didn't hurt me.
Well, the fact that Garcia, and earlier in the round, he mixed in the hook to the body. The fact that he's not mixing that punch in is even more bad news for Zab Judah.
Judah needs to take a chance here on a combination. He's got the speed to pull it off. He's landing left hands here and there. If he can follow it up with some speed combination behind the straight left hand, he may be well served, because he needs to establish a little bit of respect from Garcia.
Garcia, a decade younger than Judah, wanting to put the pressure on, wear down the veteran former champion. As we head into the final few seconds of the fourth round, another right hand lands by the champion.
This fight's starting to look a little bit like Judah Khan, and that's not good for Zab Judah.
In that fight, he was vanquished in the fifth round by Amir King Khan. So, and this was the round that Garcia said he would eliminate Judah, but Judah will see round number five. Earlier tonight in a super middleweight bout, Barclays Center in Brooklyn, playing host to another one of Brooklyn's favorite sons, Danny Jacobs, faced Keenan Collins, and he stunned him, knocking him down twice in the fourth round before the referee, Shada Murdoch, stepped in to protect the fallen fighter. That came at the 206 mark of round four, and with that TKO victory, Jacobs improving to a good career here with 22 knockouts. And of course, even better news for Danny Jacobs, the fact that he felt another lump in his back, went to the doctor, and discovered that it was not cancerous. He remains cancer-free. He remains the miracle man. And here he is in attendance, surrounded by his family after another scintillating win, improving to 25-1 with 22 KOs.
Lovely young man and a very fine fighter.
Also the recent winner of the Purge and Overcoming Adversity Award by the Boxing Writers Association of America.
Boy, did he do that. And let's see now what kind of adversity is in store for either Garcia or Judah here in round five, as Garcia again looking to walk down the challenger. Judah wanting to slip the punches, catches those shots on his arms. Oh, lands a nice overhand left.
And daunting numbers in the last round. 17 power punches landed by Garcia to 3 by Judah.
And a few seconds ago, you saw Judah land a good straight left hand, but Garcia came right back with 2 shots of his own. And this is what I mean about Judah needing to come with a combination behind the left hand, because Garcia started to, a lot like Peter Crowley did in the first fight, waiting on the left hand and coming right back on his own.
Straight right connects by Garcia. The good news is that all of the vitriol, all the enmity has been left outside the ropes, as thus far it's been all according to the Marcus of Queensbury rules, with Garcia beginning to punish Judah as he comes back with a double jab.
And Danny Garcia, who has twice lost points because of low blows against Ashley Piafane and Aiden Hernandez, has thrown to the body a lot, but not gone low.
Has been at the belt line a few times, but you're right, has not strayed south of the equator. A minute 45 remaining in the fifth round. Garcia wanting to box out, but Judah puts the grip on him. Referee Smoker calls for the break. Garcia lands a left hook to the head and then downstairs to the body.
Garcia starting to really put those body shots in the bank.
Straight right connects. Garcia coming forward. Double pops. There's a left hook that connects.
And the right hand to the head is starting to land, because Judah's leery of those right hands to the body that Garcia is consistently throwing. He's leaving his face a little open. Good variation by Danny Garcia.
Final minute of the fifth round. Judah comes back with a 1-2 combination that's blocked by the champion. Right hand to the body by Garcia. Smoker again intervenes. So far, a great job by the referee. Ooh, that sweeping left hook just missed.
And Garcia and Judah finally tried that uppercut he's known for, but he just came up short.
He's been unable to land that punch.
Oh, and he hurts Judah with that right hand. Left hook upstairs. Judah along the ropes.
Judah's
trying to recover.
Judah's a veteran. He doesn't know how to survive. He's talking to Garcia. Let's see. 45 seconds.
Another right hand backs up Judah. Left hand, right hand to the head. Judah absorbing all kinds of punishment in the corner with 15 seconds left. Trying to fight out.
He's got a clinch, guys.
And that's exactly what he does. With with less than 10 seconds remaining in a terrific round for the champion, Danny Swift Garcia.
This is the punch from Danny Garcia, a straight right hand that wobbled Zab Judah. He's landed so many of those, but that one was flush, and Judah with some gamesmanship to try and work his way through this, urging Garcia to come forward. A very clever veteran who, even in a dire moment, has enough presence of mind to do something else to help him through this tough spot. And one more look.
And again, a left hand from Judah, nothing to follow it. Again, just like Quillen made the adjustment to Guerrero on just his sole left hand, Garcia did the same thing. He landed on the left hand, caught it, and countered it. Eventually, a fighter will adjust if you don't follow up with a combination.
Round six underway. Judah has been down 9 times in his career. He's been taught 3 times, and Judah now absorbing stiff shots from the champion Garcia. Unloading with the left hook. Judah stumbles out of the way but remains on his feet. And there's a right hand that backs up Judah. The champion beginning to tee off on the challenger. But Judah remaining steadfast. He hits his heart to show that he's got it. The 35-year-old veteran. He's been in wars.
That's that Brooklyn pride. Zab's in Brooklyn. He's not going. He's not going to go out without a fight.
He's been in there with the likes of Floyd Mayweather, Miguel Cotto. Highlight real victory over Corey Spinks in their rematch.
And listen to this crowd. Danny chants here in Brooklyn.
A thunderous chant from the electrified crowd, enjoying every single second of the action as Smoker wants to break up the Velcro-like grip from Judah.
Steve Smoker, not an intrusive referee, but he will do what he has to do if somebody's holding. Judah trying to get the left hand off.
And he rocks him with that right, and he's still on his feet. Unbelievable chin by Judah Garcia.
Garcia, got to be careful. Judah came back with some hard left hands there.
Judah clinches, wanting to clear out the cobwebs. Wants to regain its faculties. Backs up in the corner, though, right where Garcia wants him. Unloads another straight right, and Garcia just wants to hold on for dear life.
It was fascinating, as Paulie said, that Judah was able to throw a very good left hand and got one of them in, but he's not hurting Danny Garcia with those.
And even if he's not hurting him, you know Garcia's really feeling him. But that's the thing about what I was talking about earlier, Danny Garcia's mental strength and fortitude. He knows he's got his man hurt here. There's nothing that's going to stop him from trying to finish him.
And the crowd again exhorting Garcia. And I'm sure there's some cheers for Judah as well, who is showcasing his heart and not going down yet in this fight.
And there's something you don't see much, a right hook from Zab Judah actually landed.
30 seconds left in the sixth round. Garcia has been teeing off on the face of Zab Judah and yet to knock him down. Judah now looking to establish the jab, as it seems like he's got the bounce in his steps again. For how long? We don't know.
What a solid effort by Danny Garcia.
And he told us this was the best training camp of his career. And he looks great.
Garcia continues to rack up the points. We're through six.
Danny Garcia had this moment early in the round. He had Zab Judah against the ropes. And we will see how he wobbled him. Literally, you could see his legs come off the canvas and did a little stutter step. And Angel Garcia, you see his reaction, and Yo Judah, very different reactions, clearly, to what they're seeing. Yo Judah used to train Zab Judah, didn't for this fight. And the right hand again, that's the one that wobbled him. Judo with left hand and right hand very, very low. And Angel Garcia is able to get the job done with that right again.
That's the thing. Judo thought he had escaped the danger zone, but Garcia found him with an extra right hand.
And 62-9 was the edge in power punches landed in the last two rounds.
At the halfway point of this title fight, there have been no knockdowns, but Judo's legs were wobbled with 37 seconds left in round five from an overhand right. He survived the rest of the round, but he lost a lot of steam in his punches after that. He was hurt again, a minute 18 into round six. Official scores at the halfway point out.
We are in virtually complete agreement. Paulie and I with a slightly bigger edge than our colleague Steve Farrow, who's got a four-point edge for Garcia, but clearly that we're in general agreement.
Judah double pumps the jab, counter right hand from Garcia. Opening minute of the seventh round, and a very patient Garcia, very composed, wanting to show off all of his wrinkles, talked about being faster than he was in his last fight here at the Barclays Center against Morales, told us that he sees punches better. What has impressed you the most out of Garcia in this fight, Paulie?
I'll tell you, just the variation. You know, he's went to the body, he's gone to the head, he's mixed the kind of right hands he's thrown. You know, he's stalking his man just like he always does once he knows he has him. Mental strength is always there, but I like the offensive variation. Yet he stayed alert to the defense.
And yet, Al, Judah's been there, done that, will not go down without a fight.
Well, you know, some have questioned his intestinal fortitude. One of the things he's showing here tonight is just that. And even gamesmanship to help him get through the rough moments. But what he needs, and he's tried, is to land something big in terms of a counterpunch.
His speed has slowed down as Garcia begins to attack the body again. Under a minute remaining in the seventh round for the WBA and WBC super lightweight titles and the Ring Magazine 140-pound crown held by Garcia, digging away at the body with the left hand. Ducks down and Judah connects. Judah misses with that left cross. Smoger calls for the break.
And remember, the second portion of fights is where Zab Judah has issues.
And we are in the second half of this tilt as Judah comes forward, sticks a stiff left hand into the face of Garcia. Right hand downstairs, and that may have been a little below the belt line. Steve Smoger saying it was legal, but just barely. Keep fighting. Sweeping left hook misses from Garcia. Final 10 seconds. Another action-packed round here as Garcia and Judah are headed to round eight at the Barclays Center in Brooklyn.
That's what I said, Garcia. You're living longer than you want. Listen, Garcia.
You gotta go to your left and stop catching the shots. You're trying to slip at the count. I don't want that. I want you to earn it. I don't want to give it to you. Look for your shot. Don't stand in for the count. Because then you can sacrifice yourself. All right?
Lift it up.
All right.
Time to jab, man.
Throw them for it, champ.
You know what? I throw them off the leg.
We're going for it.
Use the leg. No, just like, I need another round. Just like
one of the punches like for Danny Garcia, straight a little bit low. Here's the right hand. It was on the belt line. It might have been a touch low, but I think Steve Smoger decided not to give him a warning because that's the first time it's happened. And Steve wasn't in the perfect position to see that one.
We are set for the eighth round. Danny Garcia, WBA and WBC super lightweight champion in the black, white, and green. Zab Judah, former 140-pound champion, former unified welterweight champion in the black and white.
And you know, some subtle changes in the last round. For the first time, Judah landed more punches than Garcia, 19 to 12, according to show stats. And for the first, the lowest number of punches thrown by Garcia was 49 in that last round. So we'll see if that subtle change can push this fight a little more in Zab Judah's direction. And there are the numbers that demonstrate what I was talking about. And the 40% landed by Zab Judah, very impressive. That's a good percentage.
Garcia's been able to execute two good right hands to the body. Judah circling away, but into the area of that left hook, the lethal left hook of Danny Garcia. We saw stop Amir Khan and Eric Morales.
Would you have ever expected after the sixth round that the seventh would have been a good round for Zab Judah?
And he's having a pretty good round here in round eight.
I mean, he was in all kinds of trouble for a couple of rounds.
He says he's cleaned up his lifestyle. He's now a family man, and his family in attendance. His wife, Christina, his kids, Destiny, Zabria, little Zab are in attendance. Oscar De La Hoya tweeting that Brooklyn is keeping Zab up. He's showing a lot of heart. And the Brooklyn faithful enjoying every second of this championship affair.
Oh, those body shots by Garcia, man. He's feeling old.
Great exchange, and down goes Judah. Straight right hand through the guard.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Judah goes down for the 10th time in his career, and a nasty cut has opened up under the left eye of the challenger.
I don't know if I was seeing things. I kind of saw Zab landed a good straight left hand right before that. Garcia didn't even blink. He came back with his own power right hand and dropped him.
Final minute of the eighth round, which has included a knockdown by the champion. And the one saving grace for Judah Al's, the cut is underneath the eye.
Yeah, that at least is something to be happy about. And there's less than a minute left to go in this round, so the knockdown came not at the beginning of the round.
Left hook connects by Garcia. Under 30 seconds remaining in the eighth.
So much for the Judah momentum, however, in this fight.
It's been snuffed out by that knockdown. Again, the 10th of his career. He's been stopped three times, but he valiantly fights back.
Funny, I don't think he's as hurt as he was when he didn't go down.
Yeah, I agree with you.
You could have questioned the mental resolve of Zab Judah in the past, but he has shown that in the face of adversity here tonight, he is trying desperately to remain in the game.
The knockdown of Zab Judah would come courtesy of what else? A right hand. That's been the main punch in this fight that Garcia has used. And he was off balance, yes. Probably not as hurt, as you pointed out, Paulie, as he was earlier in the round. And you made the point, that's true. Straight left hand landed.
And that's also the right hand that cut him, too. So the right hand did land clean.
And as the left hand of Zab Judah that Paulie and I talked about, landing first before the right hand gets in front by Garcia.
And that's what I mean about Danny's mental fortitude and strength. He commits to the punch. He commits to the game plan, even in the face of danger. That straight left hand was booming from Zab. But Garcia was in position to counter with the right. He didn't care that he got hit with. He's almost programmed like a robot to come right back.
New York State Athletic Commission Dr. Victor Cabe inspecting Judah's cut in between rounds, allowing him to continue. Garcia comes out like a house of fire, attacking and looking to exploit that cut, but Judah lands a straight left hand.
You know, this is a very intriguing fight. It is a one-sided fight, but one that still has drama involved in it, and partially because of Zab Judah's resolve and his occasional successes.
Paulie, you fought here in your hometown of Brooklyn. What does it mean to have that crowd behind you? Is it something that we in the media make a bigger deal of? Oscar De La Hoya tweeted it out. Are you cognizant of what's happening with the crowd when you're in there?
Absolutely. It gives you a little bit more sense of pride. You know, in a way, Oscar's right. It keeps you up. You know, you want to get through the adversity. It gives you a little bit more to dig deep for, because you want to get through the adversity for your crowd, for your people. You know, you don't always get a chance to fight in front of them. So the opportunity you get like this, you know, you want to perform as best you can. You want to pull all the stops. You want to dig deep when you have to.
Danny Garcia is 2-0 in 12-round fights. Zab Judah is 5-3 as we head into these final championship rounds.
And Garcia landing a pair of stiff right hands, one to the rib cage, the other to the side of the head. Measuring up the challenger, Judah along the ropes. Garcia flashes the right hand, Judah quick to clinch.
Hands up, guys.
And again, I love how Garcia is staying with the game plan. He's not getting excited. He's still mixing those right hands, doubles them up, loops them, and straightens them out depending on the situation. Still varying. Although Judah keeps himself alive here with these straight up hands here and there.
Showing a lot of maturity as the 25-year-old champion. Showing a lot of guts and guile as the 35-year-old challenger. Judah flashes a jab. Counter right hand connects by Garcia.
Zab Judah is mentally engaged in this fight. We saw him not mentally engaged toward the end when he was fighting Amir Khan. He is tonight, and so that's why he's still a problem for Danny Garcia.
Under a minute remaining in the ninth round. Judah's right hand down along the waistline. Clinches again. Garcia walks him down. Launches the jab. Right hand to the body by the champ.
The problem for Judah is that nothing big that he has landed, and there have been some several really good straight left hands, has appeared to hurt Garcia or even stop him.
Danny's got a great chin, an underrated chin.
Yes, agreed. Probably a lot of things about Danny Garcia that are underrated.
Yeah, I mean, people should stop. Eventually, you know, you got to understand, this kid is a great fighter.
Coming into his own tonight again after that breakout year in 2012, two victories over the Mexican legend Eric Morales, the stunning upset of Amir Khan. And now putting the titles on the line against Zab Judah in what has been a terrific tilt.
Give Zab credit, man. He's showing a lot of heart. He's not going out without a fight.
And of course, we'll be back here at the Barclays Center in Brooklyn coming up on June 22nd when our Showtime colleague and WBA welterweight champion Paulie Malignaggi fights Adrian Broner, who moves up two weight classes as he makes his Showtime boxing debut. And if the official weigh-in for this fight yesterday was any indication, we can expect a lot of trash talking in that one as Garcia launches a right bomb.
Zab Judah is likely in a situation where he can't win a decision. I think we can safely say that. But he is landing some power
punches.
Beautiful
combination by Judah. Double pumped the jab that landed the straight left.
He's got to stay consistent with that, but he's also got to stay alert because you saw once again, Danny missed it, but he came right back with the right hand.
Garcia's never been down in his career, so that's a daunting task for Judah to get him down, let alone out.
And we saw Judah go down a minute 40 into round 8 from an overhand right, the 10th time in his career that he's been down.
And that's a credit to Danny's chin. He's not even gotten down here or even been hurt. You know, a lot of those straight left hands from Zab Judah have knocked down a lot of guys.
Yes. 29 to be exact.
Straight left clips Garcia's jaw by Judah. Conditioning doesn't really appear to be much of a factor yet as we are here in the going through the midway point of round 10. Both still remaining in the pocket. Judah launches a Hail Mary left and he hurt Garcia.
Steve Smoker, if he's criticized for anything, it's being too laissez-faire. And right there, he kind of said, go ahead, boys.
And the crowd
yourself
erupting vociferously when Judah landed that left hand.
And let me tell you something, guys. Danny's playing it off, but he must be hurt. He's not throwing any punches. He's committing only to defense, pretty much.
An amazing atmosphere in the great fight city of Brooklyn, New York. Under a minute remaining in the 10th. And really, Judah enjoying a second wind here.
You hear the Judah chant, the crowd getting behind him.
And he gets tagged there by the champion. Ebb and flow of the sweet science. It's been mainly Danny Garcia, but Judah remains in the pocket. And it looks like he is definitely taking Garcia out of his comfort zone in this round.
And a right hook by Judah lands after a straight left hand. He is having his moment here in this round.
The best round of the fight for the challenger, Zab the jab.
If you're going to do well against Danny Garcia, it'll come from backing him up.
And the chants of Judah echo through the confines of the Barclays Center in Brooklyn. We are headed to what should be two sensational championship rounds.
And I'll say this, man. Anybody that says Zach fades late, he just showed those people I do not fade late.
An important round for Zab Judah. That's the left hand that started the issues for Danny Garcia. As Paulie pointed out, his offense stopped at that point in the round. Yet another look at it shows you, with the pawn jab as a range finder, Zab Judah lands what we have pointed out, a punch that has knocked many a junior welterweight down and out. And later on in the round, this would be, I believe, the right hook. Yes, Zab Judah throwing a rare right hook. He doesn't throw that punch much, but it was powerful.
Yeah, he's kind of surprised him. Danny thought he had a good hold of him. The jab got his right hand free to hook off.
The crowd on its feet as we head into the championship rounds for the WBA and WBC super lightweight titles. Danny Garcia, the champion. And while it may be one-sided on the scorecards, the fans here are certainly getting their money's worth.
Well, Zab Judah changed the tenor of this fight in the last round, landing 10 power punches to only 5 for Garcia, and his 10 were very powerful.
And there is a plenty of pep in Judah's step here in round 11. Moving laterally, Garcia comes forward with right hand, misses with the jab. The straight right, though, connects on the jaw. Garcia comes in again, feints with the right, then lands the right hand to the head. Counter left by the champion. And now Garcia beginning to once again find his rhythm.
I like what Garcia is doing. Instead of panicking, he's going back to what he was doing in the early rounds. Yep. Just staying calm and mixing those right hands. He keeps that busy on defense.
And he's parrying Judah's jab.
Got to be a little careful though. He's pushing those rights to the body a little bit, and Judah may come with the left over it.
Does a good job of avoiding that left hand as the champion sidestepped the oncoming Judah. As we near the midpoint of the penultimate round, round 11. Garcia digging away at the body. Judah avoids the left, sticks the jab.
Judah, though, has not been that offensive minded in this round. He must know that he's behind on the scorecards in a way that would make it seem impossible to win a decision.
Thank goodness we're in New York and not Texas, where he would know.
He needs to leave. Well, that was the WBC rule, yeah. He certainly needs something dramatic in these last two rounds.
Left hand downstairs, right hand to the head by Garcia. Final minute of the 11th. Left hook connects by Judah.
Just like you said, Al, lazy right hand downstairs. Judah countered it. Stoppage is Zab's right shoe. The shoelace is untied.
Unscheduled respite here in round 11 with 40 seconds left.
Come in.
Powerful straight left by Judah. Connects with the right hand, and the crowd reacting to every single strike from Brooklyn. Zab, a super Judah. Who, instead of fading, is gaining confidence here again in the 11th round.
And again, the right hook emerges. A rare weapon, but a good one for Judah.
And a good body shot by Judah there, too.
Blood now trickling down the, from the hairline of the champion. Puts together a blistering three-punch combination. A flurry of punches here as we go to the 12th and final round of this terrific championship bout. Former two-time world champion Andre Berto is on his feet. And how would you not be after seeing the action we have witnessed here tonight? They're tending to the cut, which could have been the result of a headbutt. We have not been able to confirm that at this time.
The location would lead to tell you it was either a headbutt or an elbow. It was right on top of the scalp. You usually don't get cut with a punch.
In the last round, Judah landed that left hand. Garcia tried to counter with the left hook, but that was what turned the action in that round, and then later on in the round, as Garcia clawed both the right hook and the left hand landed for Zab Judy. Show a little more diversification as we head into the final round.
The bell, the 12th and final round for the WBA and WBC 140-pound championship. Referee Steve Smoker has confirmed that the cut in Garcia's scalp was the result of an accidental headbutt.
Again, a counter left hand from a lazy right hand to the body from Garcia.
For the first time, Judah tried a counter left uppercut. We haven't seen it for 11 rounds. He finally tried it. It didn't work.
And again, they clashed, the southpaw and the conventional fighter. We've seen this happen before, so.
Okay, let's go.
The cut over Judah's eye from an accidental clash of hands and the cut on Garcia's hairline as Judah lands a straight right to the body. They are bloodied, they are battered, but they're still standing here in the 12th and final round.
That clash of hands, a bad break for Zab Judah. It affected him a little more, and he's the one that needs to make something happen in this round. So that cost him precious seconds and a little momentum.
And he's trying to make things happen with a 1-2 combination. A minute 45 left in the fight. Straight right hand down the middle by the gym.
There's another cut on Garcia's forehead, and it is just leaking down his face.
Probably from that clash of heads.
Judah double pumps the jab and clinches again with Danny Garcia wearing the vestiges of what has been an epic confrontation here at the Barclays Center in Brooklyn. Left hand off the ropes by Judah.
Zab Judah has put together a rally toward the end of this fight, but and I thought he won rounds 10 and 11. Even if he takes this round, though, you have to think it might not be enough for him to win this decision.
No, it's not. He needs a knockout.
He went down in round 8, the 10th time in his career, but since then has rallied.
Oh.
Right hand connects by Garcia. Less than a minute left in the bout.
I like how both guys are going at it this round. They're not playing it safe at all.
They're imposing their will and their skill on each other. Neither man willing to give an inch, and there's a front face lock by Judo. I understand trains in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu might have been going for the guillotine choke. And look at this action here in the last 30 seconds of the bout.
Judo landed a very good straight left hand a moment ago.
We would have loved to see this earlier from Zab Judah. He's taking more chances, and his speed and combination punching rally with the land punches, even if he's getting hit back.
Judah, the offensive catalyst here with 13 seconds left. Again, they clinch. Final 10 seconds of what has been a scintillating bout for the WBC and WBA 140-pound championships. They are throwing leather until the final bell. And look at that sign of sportsmanship. Squash the beef after what was a memorable championship clash.
So for anybody that wants to talk about Zab Judah fading late, he gave it his all to try to pull out this win late.
It's ironic that usually that's an issue for him tonight, not so.
Even if he was bleeding and battered, he came hard. He came strong in those late rounds.
A fantastic way to kick off what is essentially a unofficial 140-pound tournament as we see Danny Garcia and Zab Judah go the distance. I think Zab Judah answered a lot of questions about his mental toughness.
Yeah.
up, all right, kiddo? You can't stare us like that. You got to do it. You got to tell them.
Just pull it out.
Well, we see all the blood from these two fighters, and here's part of the reason why. They banged heads in that last round, and both men suffered from it.
Oh,
that was tough. And, you know, Judah originally looked like he got the worst of it, and you could see the pain. But it also created that cut on the forehead of Danny Garcia. And, of course, in the middle of this, there were also a few punches landed, like those from Zab Judah, who also had a very good 12th round and, in my mind, swept the last three rounds. But it wasn't that Garcia didn't have his moments. He did toward the end of the round especially. That right hand was one of them. And the blood already bothering Judah there. The reaction by the families as they watch, and it is tough to watch sometimes and exciting to watch at the same time as you watch your loved ones trying to get the job done in the 12th round.
Yeah, that was team and family Garcia there.
Yep. And quickly they forget all of the animosity, all of the drama leading up to this championship bout. Forget about the trash talking. They delivered a classic championship bout here tonight, a terrific fight. And the security light is back in there, although...
I don't know
if they need it now.
Yeah, that's exaggerated, guys. I mean, come on. The fight's over. You know, they showed good sportsmanship after the bell. There's no need for that security line.
That's the...
Something tells me we might see it again on June 22nd.
Yeah, I don't mind. Before the fight, you got to do what you got to do to make sure nothing crazy happens. But the fight's over, man. I mean, there's no need for that. That's just... I don't know what that... That's just flexing muscles for no reason.
Bernard Hopkins in there we saw.
You're fighting. You are fucking suffering, man.
I want to remind you that immediately following this telecast of Showtime Championship Boxing, it's a Showtime Boxing Special Edition from Sheffield, England. Amir Khan is back in the UK for the first time in 2 years as he takes on former two-time lightweight champion Julio Kid Diaz at a catch weight of 143 pounds. That's immediately following tonight's fight.
We look at the show stats, and we see that Judah narrowed the margin a bit with those last three rounds when he started to land good punches, but still came up about 58 punches shy according to show stats. And, of course, how those punches are divided among the rounds is important, but clearly Danny Garcia throwing more and ultimately landing more.
We are set for the official decision. Let's make it official with Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 12 rounds of action, we have a unanimous decision. Here are the score totals. Judge at ringside, Tom Schreck, scores the bout 115 to 112. Judge Anik Hong Tong Kam scores the bout 114 to 112. And Judge at ringside, Adelaide Bird, sees it 116 to 111. All three in favor of the winner. And still undefeated world champion, Danny Swift Garcia.
Danny Garcia improves to 26-0. No need for Zab but Judah to hang his head as he was in the fight for all 12 rounds. Not a great start, was knocked down in the eighth and then rallied.
Excuse me, guys.
Excuse me, Dan. Man, he took care. He does a lot. Hold on, let him do his thing. Go ahead. You ready? Go, come on.
Let's get up to Jim Gray, who's standing by with the champ.
Morrow, thank you very much. Danny, congratulations to you.
Danny, you're WBC belt.
How would you describe this fight?
Woo! It was a hell of a fight, man. I came to Brooklyn. I had to beat the Brooklyn guy in his hometown. I knew he had a lot of pride behind him. I knew he was never going to give up. And I had to beat the hometown guy in his hometown. But you know, first of all, sorry, I forgot. I want to thank God. I want to thank Al Haymon, my dad, and Golden Boy and Showtime for this opportunity.
You were able to dominate with the power punches, and then you knocked him down in the eighth round. But rounds 10, 11, and 12,
yes.
Zab Judah came back, and yes. he stunned you, he alarmed you, yeah. and he won those rounds.
Yeah.
What changed?
He's a crafty veteran with power. We knew that. He hit me with a good shot, I think, about the 11th. He hit me with a left hand. He spun me around. I wasn't looking. He hit me with an uppercut, and that kind of took my, you know, shook me up a little bit. But I'm a true champion, and I got to fight through a storm in order to be a champion, and I proved that tonight.
Now you've beaten Khan. You've beaten Morales. You now beat Judah. Was Judah the best fighter you have faced?
Yeah, Judah, no doubt. Judah is the most craftiest and the strongest guy I've fought so far.
Let's take a look at that knockdown, if you can have you look right here at the monitor, Danny, in the eighth round. He hit you with a good left, and then you came back right away with the right. Tell us what happened.
Oh, he threw a left, and I just countered right back. Right on the feet.
Did you feel as though you'd be able to follow up and put him away, or was it just a flash shot?
No, I knew he throws a lot of power with the left, so I was trying to stay my ground and fire right back and land it.
Danny, you were very effective tonight without using your jab much. Is that something you're going to have to start to use a little bit more?
Oh, man, I give respect to Zab. He took the jab away. You know, my game plan was to come in here and use the jab, but he was stepping around. He was crafty. He took my jab away, so I had to use what I had and squeeze it out.
There was such bad blood between you two before this fight, particularly a lot of trash talking. It spilled over. Your dad was involved. Is that gone now?
Oh, yeah. To me, it's gone. It's a respect. As you can see, it's a lot of bad blood. I got cuts. He got cuts. We came here. We gave the people in Brooklyn a great show. I want to thank you guys for coming out. Philadelphia, Brooklyn. Thank you.
On Showtime on May 18th, we're going to have Matisse against Peterson. Would you like to face that winner?
No doubt. It doesn't matter to me. It's up to Al Heyman. Whatever he wants to do, I do. I'm the fighter. My job is to train. My dad trains me. We get ready for the fight, and we fight whoever.
Who do you think will win that fight?
I think Peterson will win.
All right. We look forward to it. Congratulations. Let's turn around. Zab Judah, that was an outstanding effort tonight by you, Zab. When you look back on this fight, are you going to wonder why you couldn't be so effective earlier and why you were so effective in rounds 10, 11, and 12?
You know, first of all, I want to thank my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, for just allowing both fighters to come out of this fight safe. And, you know, it was a pretty bad cut. Ooh, ugly. But, you know, just allow us both to come out of this ring safely. And, you know, I mean, it's boxing. Things happen. You win some, you lose some.
Your best punch of the fight came in the eighth round. You really stung him with a left, and then he turned that right around and wasn't really damaged at all by it and hit you with that right. What happened?
Like I said, I don't know what happened because I haven't seen the replay yet, but Danny Garcia is a young, tough fighter. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, I was on my A game tonight, and I worked hard. I had a great training camp. I want to thank my team, my Uncle Jimmy, Daryl, Mo, Bill Hockeyes. I mean, we did a great training camp, and we gave it our big shot.
Where would you say Garcia ranks? You fought against Mayweather, you fought against Cota. Where do you rank Danny?
I don't know yet. You know what I'm saying? The fight just got over. Let it settle in a little bit more, and I'll get the answer at a later time.
Was this the last hurrah, or will we see you fight again?
Oh, no, you're going to see me fight again. I mean, why would I quit? I mean, Brooklyn, y'all want me not to come back no more or come back? There you go. Brooklyn settled itself.
Zab, tremendous performance. We enjoyed it. Thanks so much.
Thank you very much.
All right, Morrow, back to you.
All right, Jim, thank you very much. Let's take a look at the official scoring here in New York.
The official scoring had it fairly close in this fight because of the rally. Adelaide Byrd with the widest margin, and Hong Tong Kam with a slightly smaller margin for him, and of course Tom Schreck won 15-112. All had Zab Judah having a very good second portion of the fight. And for our unofficial scoring, Steve Farhood and I at 161-11. Paulie, you had a bigger margin. Did you not give Judah as much credit for those later rounds?
The rounds I gave Judah were in the late rounds. I just felt some of the rounds I couldn't give to Judah based on him controlling 30 seconds of it. There was portions of the rounds where he had explosive shots and he landed explosive punches, but I felt like Danny was still doing the better work overall for a bigger portion of the round, so I couldn't quite get myself to give it to Judah, but I realized they were close.
Al, I just want to add that after he was knocked down in round 8, Judah did come back and won rounds 10, 11, and 12 on all three official judges' scorecards here tonight.
Yeah, they gave him the rounds down the stretch, as I did, and apparently Steve Farhood did as well.